santosyourpotentials.com, signing at our channel. Let's continue studying the book of Jack Canfield, The Success Principle. So, anong principle na po tayo? We are, so malapit na po natin siyang matapos. Principle number 48. Principle number 48 is be here, here, now. So, here po, H-E-A-R. So, listening po, hindi be H-E-R, hindi be here now, but be here now. So, listening ang challenge natin. Or, number 48 principle is listening. So, listen 100 times, ponder 1,000 times, speak once. So, source unknown po, no? Pero parang it's a saying na naririnig natin, no? So, there's a big difference daw between hearing, so yung naririnig natin, and truly listening, which is a part of paying thoughtful attention with the mind toward understanding the complete message being delivered. So, friend, yung isang secret of success pala is listening well or properly, kasi minsan or madalas dun pala tayo matututo. So sabi niya, the first one is listening pays off. So yung story ni Jack Canfield for the first lesson is meron siyang example si Miss Marcia Martin, is an executive coach. So parang yung na-receive niyang she has been conducting a lot of meetings, no? But effective ba yung meeting niya? So yung naging na-receive niyang ano is, sino ba ang nag-advise? Yung ano, boss pala. So sabi, ni-request siya nung senior vice president, si Marcia, if she could help him make his team meetings more powerful. So ano ba yung naging suggestion sa kanya? Ni Miss Marcia, who's an executive coach to the executive vice president. So, kasi no, sa office, ang daming meetings, sobrang daming meetings. Kasi sabi mo, inisip mo, are they learning? Are they listening? Meron ba silang results? No? So, I would advise you to start your meeting with just one sentence. The purpose of this meeting is for me to find out from you what you feel is going in each of your departments and what you feel the breakdowns are and what you need from me. So, naging strategy ni Miss Marcia dito sa executive advisors din is just for him to listen dun sa discussion ng team niya throughout the ilang hours pa to? 2 hours yata. So, after 3 days, kinausap ni executive, ni senior vice president nga ba, senior vice president si Miss Marcia. Sabi niya, he had the most fantastic, powerful meeting he ever had in life. He'd done exactly what he asked to do. He just listened in a way that he had never listened before. As a result, his team members had talked and talked and talked. And then, kumbaga, from what nakita niyang mga inputs ng kanyang mga tao, ng problems nila or breakdown ng term nila, dun siya gumawa ng mga strategies para matulungan sila sa trabaho nila. Galing, ano po, minsan, kumbaga, it pays to listen talaga. Then, argue less and listen more. So, ano naman to? So, minsan, like, argue less and listen more. Example niya dito is a New York photographer. Parang, so, instead na gawin yung mga shots niya, pinakinggan niya yung client niya kung ano ba yung feedback nila sa mga pictures na kinuha niya to know ano ba gusto ng client niya. So, kaya nga, argue less and listen more. You learn to argue less with the people who were paying the bills and to listen more, responding and adjusting to their feedback until they were satisfied. So, minsan kasi, no, if we are an artist or ano, parang we insist, or a coach, we insist on what we want. Hindi tayo nag-listen to sa client natin. Be interested rather than interesting. So, again, parang instead of towards us as the service provider, tignan natin yung client natin, ano ba talaga yung gusto nila, diba? Rather than to follow what it's on our mind, we follow what the client wants. So, ito pa yung powerful questions. So, ano pa ba yung how to help our clients, no? Kumbaga, or our boss, or our team members. Number one question is, if we were meeting 3 years from today, what has to be to have happened during the 3-year period for you to feel happy about your progress? So, you're in a way asking the person, ano ba yung gagawin niya to improve himself, to improve his situations, So yung focus na wala sa iyo, napunta dun sa tao na sinaserve mo or hinahandle or minimanage mo. Number two question. What are the biggest dangers you'll have to face and deal with in order to achieve that progress? So connected sa number one. Ito yung mga challenges mo. Tingin mo ano yung gagawin mo to solve those problems. So again, listening kasi parang nanggagaling ang solution dun sa kausap mo rather than just to you. So after that, think about the solution na pre-present niya, if it's achievable ba, workable, implementable, di ba? Number three question. What are the biggest opportunities that you have that you would need to focus on and capture to achieve those things? So maganda to sa strategic planning, di ba? Para sa mga tao mo. Number four, what strengths will you need to reinforce and maximize? And what skills and resources will you need to develop that you don't currently have in order to capture this opportunity? So four questions po to ask your people, to ask people around you, to ask yourself din, sabi nga ni ano, it's your turn. You have to ask also ourselves these questions and answer, sabi nga. Make sure to take yourself through the same four questions either alone or a piece of paper or verbally with a friend or a master partner. It's a valuable exercise. Stay safe, everyone. God bless you all. Thank you for watching. See you in our next video.